Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton, and this week we are looking at 8 different things that you should be doing on your website. Last week we covered the 8 things you have to stop doing on your website. So be sure to check out that video. I'll put it in the description box below so you can watch that and go today and make sure that those 8 things are not happening on your current website. Looking forward though as to what things you should be doing, let's take a look at it. The very first thing we want to talk about is mobile friendliness. Now, of course, everybody knows your website has to be responsive. You know that you should be looking at a theme for WordPress that allows that type of cool structure so it looks great on a cell phone. But there's a lot more you should be thinking about as well. You don't just want to think about how it looks on a cell phone, you know, this way or that way. You want to be checking it on iPhones. You want to be checking it on Androids. You want to be checking it on an iPad, vertical and horizontally. You want to also be checking out your website across different browsers, right? So you want to be looking at Safari. Make sure that everything on your website functions well for mobile friendliness. Google is watching that and they want you to get it right. So I'll put the link to this option for you. This is Google's mobile friendly test. You can come here and just type in your web address and click analyze, and it will go run. Google's kind of will go over and kind of review your website, see if it's good or not, and it'll give you a great report. So check that out. The other thing I want to suggest doing, number 2, is be sure that your phone number and your address on your website, if they're visible on there, are all clickable. And while smartphones these days do, in fact, read phone numbers, some do not. So you want to be sure that there might be some nerd code behind the scenes to allow that to happen. I'll show you what I mean. So over here on WebTegrity's website, if you scroll down to the bottom of our website, you'll see that our phone number is in fact clickable, and so is our address. Our address actually links over to Google Maps. So if somebody's on their cell phone, they can click on that and get directions to our office. And this right here is our click to call phone number is clickable. It has the nerd code behind the scenes. I have a video that I've already made about what type of nerd code to put behind there, and I'll put that in the description box below as well. So you can go check that out and be sure that your website is in fact clickable and user-friendly. Number 3, social media. We've really got to talk about this because even though in our no-nos last week I mentioned don't let social media be a distraction, there is a correct way to allow social media on your website that can be an advantage. Google definitely wants to see social media links happening on your website. So one of the examples I can give you is here on WebTegrity's site, we have our Twitter feed that happens inside of our blog area over here in the sidebar. We just have a free plugin that we're using for Twitter, and it pulls in our dynamic feed right there. So that's pretty cool. And of course, you can always have your links across the bottom. Last week we spoke about the placement of these icons not being a distraction. So you'll want to look at these and be sure that they're clickable, mobile friendly, they're nice and big links that people can see them. And I would highly suggest using the actual icons instead of just linked text over to your social media account so that people quickly and easily see those. Another version that you can do for social media is Instagram. There are several really cool free plugins right now that you can do and basically plug it into your website and pull your feed over from your Instagram channel directly into your website. So that's really cool. So you can take a picture from your phone, upload it to your Instagram account, and dynamically it's over here on your website. So that could be an option for you, having some really cool fresh content as well. Number 4, let's talk about this, customer reviews. Google is looking for these types of things on your website as well, and so are your customers. They're wanting to see what other people are talking about. They're wanting to see people's interaction with you and kind of what their experience was. So on WebTegrity's website, we have our client reviews page here. And of course, we also link over to our Google reviews so that people can check that out. But we've got both written testimonials as well as video testimonials. And I think a blend of both are really cool to have. So absolutely be sure to have something like that on your website. Number 5, major landing pages. You absolutely want to be sure that you're doing something where every single key term, wrap your brain around this for a second, okay? We're going to talk about SEO. Every key term that you want to rank well for, all right? So for WebTegrity, if we want to rank well for web design, we want to be sure to have a major landing page or one single page on our website that's dedicated specifically to that conversation. And we do have that. So if you come over here to our services and WordPress web design right here. You click on that. This is our singular page that specifically talks all about our different projects that we do. Every bit of text down the page specifically speaks to web design. Now, one of the reasons why we have this, obviously, is because Google wants to be able to read what your services are. And it's difficult to read your services if all you have is one page that says services and they're in a bullet point list, you know, web design, SEO, social media marketing, content writing. That's silly. That's not even enough content for Google to really sink its teeth into and understand what you're doing. So when I'm saying major landing pages, I really want you to break out and create different pages on your website that can speak specifically to the key terms that you're trying to rank well for. So talking about SEO, I have to tell you, using the free plugin Yoast inside of your WordPress website is absolutely one of the things you want to be doing, because it's like having somebody who's an SEO expert in the room with you helping you write your content. You want to have as many green lights as you possibly can, and once you start using Yoast, you'll understand that green light statement. All right, number 7, Google Analytics. If you are not currently tracking your Google Analytics, you really don't know if all of this work that you're putting into your website is even creating the traffic to get your customers excited, to get people to your website. You don't even know. So you could be thinking, you know, I've been spending a lot of time writing blog articles this month, and, you know, I've spent 20 or 30 hours. Has it gotten me any new leads? No, not really. Well, you can then go look at your Google Analytics and see, wow, my traffic has gone up though. I did in fact get 500 new visitors to my website this month. Why didn't those convert? You really need to be watching and seeing how much traffic comes to your website. Google Analytics can also help you with where they came from, what search term they were using to find you, did they come from social media, what type of browser are they using, how long did they stay on your website, what pages did they click on inside your website. It'll keep track of all of that, and it's super important for you to understand. If you don't have this linked right now to your current website, I've got another video we've already done about how to connect Google Analytics to your WordPress website. That'll be in the description box down below. Check it out. And drum roll, number 8, and this is one of the most important things you can ever be doing and you must be doing on your current website, and that is to have some really great security in place and also have a backup game plan, right? You know that WordPress always requires updates, and if you don't have a backup in place and you go to click update, you could very easily break your entire website and have what we call the white screen of death. So you certainly want to be paying attention to not only your security kind of improvements that you can do on your website. Be sure that your username is not admin. Be sure that your password is really, really secure. And then also even look at potentially using a plugin called Sucuri. It's S-U-C-U-R-I. I'll put the link to that in the description box below. And as for a backup plugin, I wanted to highly recommend Updraft Plus. This is a free backup plugin that you can install on your website. You can look how many active installs, you guys. This is incredible. They're always keeping it up to date. And one of the things that I love about Updraft Plus is not only is it super simple to install and activate, but if something ever does go wonkadoo on your website and you have to have a backup, it is a one-click restore option, and it'll automatically roll back your website and fix everything that was broken. You'll want to be sure that you're backing up not only your files, but also your database. It gives you that option inside of it, so check that box. All right, y'all, that's it. Those are my top 8 things that you have to be doing on your current website. If you have questions about these, throw them in the comments down below, and I will do my best to respond back to you. I hope you're having a great WordPress Wednesday. Stick around next week. It only gets better. Subscribe. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye, y'all.